Chief Justice Martha Koome will have to form a three-judge bench to hear a suit in which Busia Senator Ukio Mtata and human rights group are challenging the legality of the Suspended Finance Act. High Court Judge Mugure Thande says weighty matters have been raised in the petition. Thande has extended interim orders halting the government from collecting taxes outlined in the Finance Act 2023. Omtata, who is behind the petition, said the law is unconstitutional, adding that its implementation holds subject to Kenyans to great suffering. Azimio leader Raila Odinga says he remains unbowed in his push to ensure the government addresses the skyrocketing cost of living. Raila, who on Monday held a series of public engagements in Nairobi CBD, stressed that he will not relent despite an alleged assassination attempt on him during last Friday's Saba Saba demonstrations. The Azimio leader urged Kenyans to back his bid of collecting 10 million signatures to show dissatisfaction with the leadership of President William Ruto.
Huyu jamaa anajulikana pale yena toka. Kila mara yeye ananiwinda kama mnyama. Naambia yeye Mungu iko. Mungu iko. Na sitarudi nyuma. Sitarudi nyuma. Sasa tumesema siku ya Jumatano. 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 Mungu tayari? Mungu tayari? Tumesema sisi si majambazi. Sisi vilevile si watu ambao wanataka ugomvi kwa sababu ya ugomvi. Tunafanya kila kitu tunafanya na sababu. Tumesema Wakenya wana sababu. Pili, Wakenya wana nia. Tatu, Wakenya wana uwezo ya kuleta mabadiliko.
The government has unearthed 40 more mass graves as phase 4 of the Shakahola cult exhumations exercise resumed. According to Interior Cabinet Secretary Professor Kithure Kindiki, 339 lives have so far been lost. Kindiki stated that every religious leader must do their work in accordance with the constitution and the laws of the country. Pastor Paul McKenzie, who allegedly told his followers to starve to death in the pretext of meeting with Jesus, is the main suspect as he is in police custody as investigations continue. And finally, the Intergovernmental Authority on Development Quartet on Sudan has implored on the warring Sudan Armed Forces and the Rapid Support Force to declare an unconditional ceasefire and establish a humanitarian zone. President William Ruto, who also chairs the IGAD Quartet, said the move will lead to the resumption of the final phase of the political process. He made the remarks in Addis Ababa during the IGAD Quartet Heads of State and Government meeting that focused on the Sudan conflict. President Ruto termed the Sudan situation as dire, with data indicating that over 2.9 million people have so far been displaced. On the other hand, the death toll stands at more than 2,000 as the crisis exerts more pressure on neighbouring countries.
I strongly condemn this senseless violence, the brutal attacks on civilians, including women and children, and the extensive destruction of property and infrastructure that is threatening the nationhood of Sudan and spurring uncertainty across our entire neighborhood. The atrocities in Darfur are alarming. The targeted interracial attacks are particularly concerning as they steadily spiral into a humanitarian catastrophe. Our meeting must address this unfolding situation. Critical is the need for an immediate assessment of the security and humanitarian situation with a view to ensuring that action is taken to protect the civilian population. While the crisis in Sudan continues to escalate, the response remains inadequate. In spite of the various challenges on the ground, it is incumbent upon us and the international community to scale up assistance to the affected populations.